So right now it's about 5 p.m. here in Sweden on January 29th, and I pretty much just got home from a gig yesterday, which was awesome. So it was a lot of fun, but you know, pretty long and exhausting day yesterday and a lot of driving today as well. But there's really no time to rest. I'm just pretty much gonna pack my bags, repack my bags rather. Get something to eat and then drive down to Landvetter Airport outside of Gothenburg here in Sweden. And tomorrow morning, early tomorrow morning, 6:45 a.m., I'm grabbing a flight down to Germany where I will be able to go to the Meinl land, basically. Meinl headquarters, Meinl factory, all of that in this little town in Germany called Gutenstetten. I've been there once, 2 years ago at the 2015 Meinl Festival, but to be able to go there now by myself and meet the people there, you know, get to know the guys that in the Meinl team and get to handpick some symbols and just get a more of a tour of the whole place. It's gonna be so awesome. It's a real dream come true for me, and I'm really excited about all of this. So I figured, you know, with this being kind of a big deal, I thought, you know, why not just make some kind of video on it, like a little vlog. But I haven't planned anything for it. I really don't know what's gonna happen. I just know I'm grabbing a flight tomorrow. I'll get picked up at Nuremberg Airport. And I just know I'm heading back on the day after, so Tuesday afternoon. That's pretty much all I know, so let's go, let's see what happens. Sorry?
This is the one you came with, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Ich habe jetzt nur eine Sache, die kam mir jetzt ein bisschen in die Quere. Und das ist, ich denke nicht, dass ich euch...
This is where the festival was, right?
Yes.
Yeah, right here. Good memories. The showroom. You're building a new building,
new
right?
Office. This is not us, but I'll turn around. Back there, we're building a new office.
Yeah. What's the reason for that?
Because we need more space.
So it's an additional office.
No,
it's not a replace. You're removing the old one.
Putting these guys in this office and us from down the street in the same office.
Okay.
And then we gain office space from here,
yeah,
which will be storage space, and our factory. We need more space in the factory.
Oh, okay. And when is this planned to be done?
In October. We're gonna move in here in October.
Yeah. A lot of work.
Well, for them.
Yeah, exactly.
Not for us.
I remember this too. It's all familiar. Factory?
This is the factory.
Yeah. In the first building?
This is packing and shipping.
Okay.
The giant conga, I've seen it on pictures.
That's a cajon right there.
Oh, that's new. It's cool.
Muss mit schnell anhören. Also wir können das heute auf jeden Fall nicht posten. Ja, zwei noch haben wir ja noch. Wie, zwei noch?
Ne, heute wollten wir noch.
Here you can film.
Yeah.
But here you cannot.
Yeah. Off limits.
Yeah.
Hello.
Servus.
Hi. Hallo, ich breche es ab, oder?
Du kannst
okay. 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 Yeah.
So these are the pure alloys, yeah?
Yeah, these are pure alloys. They're also right here.
Yeah.
No light up here.
So these are all the symbols, right? Yeah, the HCS and those over there too. Yeah. Is this where everything goes out? Through here, or? Mm-hmm.
A lot of it goes in the warehouse,
yeah.
Across the street.
It yeah.
goes from there. We ship Germany, Austria, Poland, Hungary,
mm-hmm.
etc. All the international shipments,
yeah.
like for USA, Australia, China, and so on. They are prepared here.
Mm-hmm.
Labeled, Syria.
Yeah.
Miley is a all over France.
Mm-hmm.
Greece.
Oh.
You can see a little bit.
Yeah.
Of all the others.
Oh, it's all the. It's like a percussion showroom.
Yes, that's that, basically.
Yeah. That's cool.
Yeah. This is all the Viva Rhythm.
Yeah.
Gear. Different series. Here you have from every minor drum festival.
Hmm. This is yeah. So it's from all the yeah. I recognize that one. You know.
Yeah. 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 You got one of them.
Yeah. Exactly. But how many were there of those?
Since not many. Maybe three or four.
And where are the others?
No idea. Really? I don't know how many there were actually. Could have been only two. I mean, this is one, you have another one.
Yeah.
Maybe there's a third one somewhere, but I don't remember.
Okay. Oh, that's cool. Memorial wall.
Memorial wall, yeah, exactly.
MB20, M series, Soundcaster. Rest in peace, right?
with the year. They've been around actually.
Yeah, 2009. Which the oldest is MB20? How long is the MB20?
It's Soundcaster, 2005.
Yeah.
And MB20, also 2005.
Yeah. Yeah, I think they, like you said, they're maybe a little washy for what I'm looking for. So maybe something like the vintage pure or Is the spectrum right?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is try. So I don't. Yeah, like I said, I don't know.
Pretty versatile.
Yeah, yeah. So I don't know exactly which one. It could be anyone. It's just that it has to be a lot of stick definition for that purpose. You know. There's a nice bell on this one.
Sweet.
Okay. Not much to see.
Not much to see.
How many people live in Gudenstetten? Do you know?
200.
200?
More or less.
Okay, I thought maybe it would be at least like 1,000.
No way. No way.
200 and 150 of them work at Meinl. Place?
Yeah.
Should I take my bags and everything now then?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Today was so awesome. Really, I have no words for all of this. It's just beyond amazing to be here, and it's like, I don't know, I'm at a loss of words. It's a real dream come true for me. But we're gonna get something to eat now, and then afterwards Norbert is gonna head home and I'll be spending the night here in this really nice hotel room, and I can kind of walk you guys through a little more about exactly what we did today. But for now, gotta get something to eat. I'm getting a headache. I've been up since 4 this morning. So I'll talk to you guys soon. Okay, so now it's actually Tuesday. I completely forgot yesterday evening that I was supposed to talk to you guys through the day. But basically today is the last day of my little 2-day trip. I'll be heading home this afternoon. But what we did yesterday basically was kind of what you saw. We walked around, I got a little more personal tour of the whole place and the factory. I wasn't allowed to film in there, unfortunately, but a lot of cool stuff going on in the whole production. What I can say though is basically they make everything there except for the Biosense models, which come in from being handmade in Turkey, so they get the blanks, like, the, you know, they still have some stuff they need to finish with them. Those come into this factory here in Germany, and they basically finish them up here. Everything else is made from scratch with the blanks that they buy in here at the actual Meinl factory here in Germany. So basically that's kind of, you know, a lot of machines and stuff in there, but I can't show you guys that, unfortunately. But that's the whole production, and then it goes into that big showroom, the big, you know, room with all the shelves with symbols where they kind of quality control them and stuff before shipping them out. But basically, we got a tour of the whole place, and the main purpose I'm here from the beginning is to handpick new symbols for my setup. Since I do a lot of session work, like recording songs, and I do some specific gigs and stuff, the setup I have works for mostly everything, but I need some more specific sounds, you know what I mean? Because, say, for example, my ride is the biggest department that's lacking a bit. Is that ride I have, the limited edition one, it's a great all-around ride, but it's not very specific, you see what I mean? So if I'm playing music that requires a really soft, like really woody, stick definition jazz ride, I don't have that. My ride is too washy. And if I'm playing metal, where I need a really cutting, like, you know, clingy sound, like that really just, you know, cuts through everything, my ride doesn't really do that either. It's too much wash. So I need to replace some cymbals that I've had for a long time and beat the hell out of them, starting to develop some cracks. So it's better to replace them now before they start cracking too much, just to have backups and stuff while I'm here, and also some new stuff, like a little splash, the dual splash that I was really been really wanting to try for a long time, and it's the perfect splash for me. So basically what I picked now, I'll tell you really quickly what I picked, is the 10-inch dual splash, because like I said, it's the perfect splashdown for me. Another 18-inch Bison's dual crash, because it's my favorite crash ever. And to replace my 20-inch extra thin hammered, the idea was to maybe, like, basically I was open for ideas there. I wanted to try something new. So we ended up with a 19-inch extra dry thin crash. I've never played the 19-inch, and it actually sounds really cool. The one, you know, we had to try like 10-15 before I found that perfect one for my taste. But that one sounds really good. So it's a 19-inch extra dry thin. For the ride department, we picked a 22-inch Bison's Big Apple Dark Ride for the jazzy stuff. Might change that today. It sounds awesome, but I actually completely forgot to try the 24-inch of the same version, the same model, sorry. And there's also the Bison's Dark Raw Bell Ride that I really want to try that I completely forgot as well. It's too many, you know, so many options in there, I just forget everything. But I want to try those today. If any of those sound even better, I'll pick that instead. But for now, it's a 22-inch Bison's Big Apple Dark Ride for the jazz stuff. For the more metal kind of stuff, we picked a symbol I've also been wanting to try forever. The Bison's Brilliant Serpent's Ride, which is Derek Roddy's signature ride. It's a 21-inch. And it's basically like almost like the MB20 stuff, like a really cutting bell. It's the same kind of bell that just cuts through everything and sounds awesome. But this one is a little more open, just a little bit more washy and all around than, say, the MB20 stuff that's really, like, you know, really just for metal. This is a little more all around, but it's, you know, it's perfect for what I need. So that one was, you know, no-brainer. We just tried it, I was like, this is the one. And tried a few, found the perfect one, and here we are. So, and I think that's, you know, I'm forgetting one thing. For hi-hats, I love my hi-hats that I have, the 16-inch extra dry, medium-thin hi-hats. But I was looking, I also have a pair of 15-inch Bison's Dark hi-hats. So the 16-inch extra dry, they're my all-around hi-hats. I love them, I use them for pretty much everything. And for stuff that's a little more like metal, or when I'm playing some gigs where I need the hi-hats to cut a bit more, I use my 15-inch Dark hi-hats. But I was missing something a little in between. I wanted to experiment a bit. Something that bridges the gap, something that's really buttery, but also has a nice chick sound, and that kind of, you know, works more as an all-around, because extra dry, you know, they're great all-around hi-hats, but sometimes they're a little too dry. You know, it depends on the music, depends on what I need them for. So I would want to have one more option. So we experimented a bit, I had some ideas we wanted to test, and we tried something I wanted to do for a long time, which is basically create a set of 16-inch dual hats, because the dual hi-hats are only available in 15. So I wanted to try a 16-inch dual crash as the top and something else as the bottom. So we ended up with a 16-inch dual crash on top and the bottom lid of a 16-inch traditional medium hi-hat. We just took the bottom lid and used that for this combination. And it's basically like a dual hi-hat, but, you know, on steroids. Like a little deeper, a little bigger, and a really nice chick sound due to the kind of heavy bottom. And they just, you know, you'll hear them. You'll hear what I mean when I get them sent home to me, because they sounded really awesome. It turned out to be a great combo. So that's going to be a lot of fun to mess around with. But for now, today's a new day. I'm going to get some breakfast, and we're going to go back to the factory and everything, and we're going to do a live stream on Instagram and on the Meinl Facebook and everything. And basically, I'm just going to try some more symbols. People that watch the stream can request stuff, and we'll pick them out, and we'll try them. It's just kind of for fun. It's not a sales pitch or anything. It's just, you know, while I'm here, it's fun to try stuff, and also we can get people to request things they want to hear, like different combinations or just symbols they want to hear. Then that's awesome. So it's going to be a lot of fun. That's kind of what the day is today. Just this morning before lunch, we can do that and make sure I have everything I want for my setup. And then we're just going to go back to the airport. I'm grabbing my flight at around 2-3 this afternoon. And I'll be home in my own apartment maybe at around 9 or 10 tonight. So that's what the day is going to look like. So let's get going.
Oh yeah.
That's why I leave them here. When I get the 18-inch back, then I
okay. Ship them out. Good.
Got everything?
Yep. All good. The rest is in the car.
Okay.